Now, last week we were in agreement that if we are to be successful this year, we must discover our unique gifts. Because God created each one of us unique to the other. And it is these gifts that are unique to ourselves that are going to give us value. It is this value that's going to attract money. We are going to get paid because of these values that are derived from our unique gifts from God. Now, it's also written in the Bible in Isaiah chapter 48, verses 17. Thus says the Lord, your Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel. I am the Lord your God who teaches you to profit, who leads you in the way you should go. If only you had paid attention to my commandments, then your well-being would have been like a river and your righteousness like the waves of the sea. If we pay attention to God, our wellness will be like the river. We'll be wealthy, we'll flow and overflow and never end. And the Bible says, remember in Matthew chapter 6:33, that seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. And all these gifts and these values and these amazing things that will attract wealth and growth this year will be added unto you. But how do we discover those gifts? That's the discussion for today. And joining us on the show as usual is our teacher. His name is Servant Hilary from the Kingdom Revelation Church of Uganda. Servant Hilary, good to have you on the show.
I'm very much humbled to be here, Brother Daniel.
Amazing.
Yes.
These special gifts.
Yes.
Before we even go into discovering them, yes. What are these gifts?
If we are to talk about the gifts, there are very many. Okay, gifts, this is a God-given purpose in life. So, and if we are to discuss about them, there are very many. I always tell people, like, how you see the body, the human body. Now we have the eyelids, we have the teeth, we have the tongue, we have the beards, we have a lot of things on the body. So that is the exact thing to the gifts of humans. There are very many, many gifts. To an extent that each one of us, almost 8 billion people on our planet now, we have a distinct gift, each one of us. So if we're talking about gifts, we're talking about almost 8 billion gifts on our planet. So God-given potentials, that is a gift. That is the blessing. That is the purpose why I was created. Yes, that is all about, that is what we call a gift.
It's a gift.
Yes.
Literally, a doctor is a gift.
Exactly.
Being a doctor is a gift.
Exactly.
Being a lawyer is a gift. Being an artist is a gift.
It is.
And if we discover this, we'll get wealthy. Now,
amen.
Let's talk about discovering our gifts, which is our main discussion today.
Mm-hmm.
What are the stages,
yes,
that would lead us to discovering who we are?
Yes, let me first throw in this idea in the minds of our viewers. And it is just in this story. It happened to be there was a grandmother and a granddaughter.
Yes.
And what happened is the grandmother got very sick and she was about to die. And she was like, okay, there is something I need to give to you before I die. And what the grandma did, she gave a necklace to this granddaughter, a necklace, yes. And it looked a bit weird. It wasn't all that on fashion.
Yes.
depending on the generation of the granddaughter.
Yes.
So, and the mother died and she said, yeah, before she died, she was like, I've given you this necklace and it is your wealth. And this daughter was like, seriously, what is this? Because it was almost out of fashion.
Yes.
And, you know, she was so much into this need for money. And she was like, how am I going to survive with this thing? How can this thing help me? And, you know, the daughter took this necklace to a shop. And she was like, can you give me some money out of this necklace? And the shop was like, let me look at it. And as they looked at the necklace, they were like, no, this is so much out fashion. We can't give you so much money. Anyway, we can just give you pennies of dollars into this. And the girl was like, no, this is too small. This is a gift from my mother. And she told me this is something of importance. How dare you tell me that you're going to give me such a penny of monies? And she left the place. And okay, she took the necklace to the relatives and she was like, okay, grandma left me this. Do you mind paying me this, giving money into this and you stay with this? And they were like, okay, let me see. We grew up seeing the thing. We can't give you so much money to this. Okay, it is a souvenir, but the thing is, we can't give you enough money. So we can't just give you pennies. And she was like, no, it isn't worth what the mother told me. To cut the story short, this girl tried many different places, but it was like people did not value the thing. And what happened, she took the necklace to the to the to the to the, how is it called? These towers where they keep The stores where they keep these things of, you know, long time things which I've spent so much
time.
Museum, yes.
Yes.
She took the necklace to the museum. And what happened is, when she reached there, the museum guy was like, wow, where have you got this? And she said, yeah, my mother gave me this. And the museum person said, my love, this is a very, very wonderful and expensive antique. So how much do you want in this? And she was like, no, you have to tell me because I have the value. I know the value of the thing. Though she did know a lot about the value. And the guy was like, we can give you $100,000.
Just for this.
$100,000. And the guy was like, seriously? And they're like, yes. And she sold the antique and she earned the money. Anyway, in that story, what do we learn from this? As we are talking about gifts, there are many, many places that they won't appreciate your gift. You have to know that. No, no, people are going to appreciate your gift. But there is a certain place. There's a certain place.
Where it is meant to serve.
Where it is made to serve.
Interesting. It's God will give you a gift which is not going to be put to waste.
Exactly.
Everybody is uniquely useful somewhere.
Exactly.
You've got to find your ministry.
Exactly.
Your area.
Exactly. So if you go somewhere and you're not appreciated, that does not mean that your gift
it
is
may
not
just be the right place.
Exactly.
But you have a gift inside you, which is so much alive.
Exactly. And if it reaches to the right people in the right place, I'm telling you, you can wonder who you are. So the thing is, why did I give that story? Is to tell you that you are valuable. Each one of us on our planet is valuable.
Very valuable.
Exactly. Yeah. Two, you are not a mistake. You are not a mistake. The Bible says in Ephesians chapter 1 that God chose us before the creation, before the foundation of the world. We are chosen before even the world existed. Mm. So you are valuable. I assure you. That's why we need to discover your value. We need to
know. The reason
why
God created the earth.
Yes.
The reason why he did all these things and put them in that places that they are is because of you.
Exactly.
Because he knew there was you.
Exactly.
And this is what you're supposed to do.
Exactly.
So we are the center of God's works and everything.
Exactly. Mm. And let me tell you this, God has designed everything for you. You just need to, you know, your gift is not somewhere else. You don't need to go to a counselor, you don't need to go to a pastor, you don't need to go to what. It is within you. God has hid your gift where you can't miss it. It is just inside you. But the thing is, how do we discover the gift? Mm. That is the most important thing.
Yes.
One, there are points to note. That's why I always love people with books.
Mm.
Points to make. One, your gift is just in a triangular form.
The gift is in a triangular form.
It is in a triangular form.
Mm.
The upper angle is God.
Mm.
The other left hand or the right hand is another person, fellow man. And the other angle is you. Mm. How to discover your gift? You have to have that triangle in you.
Yes, you need to have gift, God up.
Exactly.
You on the left side and the right side, other men.
Exactly.
Yes.
Why do we have to go about that? And we have to know that very clearly. The thing is, a God-given gift must first, in the first place, benefit God, his kingdom. It has to be that as you do it, it benefits God first. The other angle is it has to be benefiting other people, not yourself.
Yes.
Then at last, it benefits you. That is a God-given gift. Because what the devil is doing is to confuse these things. You know, people have their own manufactured gifts and they think this is my gift. You know, God gave me this.
It has to benefit you.
It has to benefit me first. You know, this is mine. I have to use it.
It has to benefit me first.
Exactly. If we have that triangle, it will help us even to protect us from misusing the gift.
Yes.
Because it has to be benefiting God first, others, and you. Okay. Now, as you want to find your gift, you know, we are on a battlefield. We're in a crisis. We all know that. If you read Ephesians 6, the Bible states it's very clear that we are not wrestling against flesh and blood, but against the spiritual principalities.
It's a war. It's a battle that we are living.
We are on a battlefield, yes.
Every single day we are in the battlefield.
Exactly. And as God knew that we are on a battlefield, each one of us comes as a fighter on the battle, on the side of the kingdom. So you came as a solution on a battlefield.
To the kingdom of
God. To the kingdom of God. To benefit the kingdom, other people, and yourself. That's why on this battlefield you have the doctors who are going to heal us as the devil has wounded us.
Mm.
We have the lawyers who are going to teach us. Lawyers, we are the pastors, the teachers of the word.
Mm.
We have to teach you how the constitution works and how you can go about all these things.
Mm.
We have the soldiers who are going to be fighting. We have those intercessors and what of not. So the battlefield has all people.
All sorts of people.
Exactly. You're also born to do something on a battlefield. Some of them are, they have to be chiefs, you know. Some of you guys, you are journalists, you have to give us reports on how things are going on.
That's
so that we can be updated.
Mm. Mm.
So the thing is, as we all know that we are on a crisis, we are on a battlefield, then God designed you to come here to fulfill a purpose, to benefit his kingdom, other men, and yourself. So the thing is, any God-given gift has to be a solution to society.
Mm.
That is the first principle. And this is always very simple. It always calls you. Let me tell you this.
Mm.
You know, there's something, there's that thing that you look into society and you aren't comfortable about. You're like, I don't think, why should children be treated this way? Why should orphans be treated this way? Why should widows live in such a life?
Mm.
Why should elders be treated this way? Why should they be? There is something that is always calling you. In
there's
your
something
life.
Inside you.
Inside
there,
you.
There's a desire.
Exactly.
There's some insatisfaction within
exactly.
you.
Exactly. There's something you need to
so
fix.
So the moment you start feeling that, you,
yes.
my sister, my brother, you might be just about to fit into your place.
Yes. Those people are like, how? I'm not comfortable with how the media is working. I think all media
something,
should be about the kingdom.
Something
yes.
needs to be done.
Exactly. Something needs to be done.
When you start to feel that something needs to be done.
Exactly. That means your gift is calling you. It is a gift. You are called to fix up that issue. You have to solve that problem.
Yeah.
And on the other hand, there is something that amuses you. You know, like there are those gifts like, you know, musicians.
Yes.
For them, they are not into so much fixing problems. But the thing is, they feel that thing of like every time she wants to sing, you want to sing.
She wants to say something.
Exactly. Every time if he's a mechanic, he's like so much into, you know, looking at the details of cars and, you know, motorbikes and ABCD. There are those people that have that calling, which is just obvious within them. And it's something that you get when you're young. It's not something that you just grab when you're older. No, it's something you grab when you're young. You just look at a guy like Joseph. This guy had a vision of, you know, being a leader. You know, his relatives are coming to him. He's solving their problems, working to their problems. And he was still young. But the thing is that this gift was calling him. It was just a revelation of who he was.
Yes.
So the thing is, your gift, you look at the issues that, you know, those problems that touches you so much. You know, we can be two people, like how the Bible says in Luke, you know, the guy was on a road, was so much stripped and beaten so much by thieves. But, you know, the priest came and he wasn't so much about that. The Bible says he just walked beside the road and left. You know, even a Levite came and the guy wasn't so much touched. He also left. But these are all gifts. A priest, it is a gift. And a Levite is a gift. You know, they walk into the temple.
Yes.
But a Samaritan came. Because it was his gift. The guy was like, no, I can't go away leaving this guy here. The Bible says that the guy picked the guy, he put him on his donkey, he took him to another house and was to the hospital and, you know, he paid the bills. So that is how it happens in a society.
That was his gift.
Exactly.
That's actually his calling.
Exactly. There are many things that, you know, we can look at the same thing together, but we feel differently. That means the reason is just that we are just different.
Yeah, and you can't say that I'm a pastor, I don't need anybody else.
No, it doesn't work that way.
You can't say I am such a great lawyer that I don't need a doctor.
No, it doesn't work that way.
Because even a pastor needs a doctor.
Exactly. Exactly. And he needs a lawyer too. Get the issue. So the thing is, you know, that is how the simplest way that we can discover gifts is, you know, there's that inner calling. But above all things, the one to tell you your gift is God. Above all things. Now, I should ask you a question. Who told Joseph that he was a leader? It was God.
It was God that told him.
Who told Moses that he was a redeemer? It was God that found him in a jungle and told him, he saw the bush burning and the guy was like, let me go. And it was God that told him that, you know, guy, I chose you to be a redeemer.
Even Saul, who became Paul, the apostle.
Exactly.
It was God that told him, why are you persecuting my people?
Exactly.
And he put him to another level.
Exactly. Above all things, if we are to discover gifts, we need to be in the presence of the Lord. Because he knows. It was God. In fact, Genesis chapter 1, verse 26 says, let us create man in our own image, in our likeness, so that they can have dominion over all the creation. So the thing is, it was God that told Adam that you are a manager. So we need God desperately because he's the one that knows our gone by. He knows what we must do, when and how, with who and why. So it was God who told Gideon that you were a fighter. Gideon was a guy, just he was hiding into
Gideon,
the jungle.
You know, Gideon told God, man, how am I going to do so?
How am I going to do that?
I can't
I'm not even a warrior.
You know? And Gideon kept on asking God for proof, proof.
Exactly.
God gave him proof.
Exactly.
That, yo, I have called you and I'm sending you there.
Exactly. And I should tell people that it is all about that. It is just that the devil has, you know, kept a secret of who we are. That is what he's doing. He's just burying God's gift into the dust. The thing is, if you talk about Tiger Woods, what do you think about? Tennis. If you talk about Usain Bolt, what do you think about? Running. Bill Gates, software. Schwarzenegger, film. Celine Dion, acting. You know, we all have something. It is just hidden. But the best way and the shortest way to know your gift is God. That's why you have to read your Bible. Because I always tell people, in this book, each one of us is inside here. We are just in history. There's nothing new. Even Daniel is not new. Even Hillary is not new. Even John is not new. There's nothing new. Oh, your character.
Even you who is watching, you are not new.
You are not new.
Yes.
There are those people that lived before you, exactly like who you are.
Yeah.
So the thing is, as you go through the Bible, the Holy Spirit shall help you know, discover yourself. Because the Bible, one, not only discovering, but it peels the gift. You know, it is hidden down in the ditch by sin. Your gift is hidden. I should tell you guys, even those that know that they are musicians, they don't know which kind of music they should sing. They don't even know singing where, why and what, when. They don't know. They just sing. That's why you find people, they have their gift, but their gifts are just misused.
And let me just remind our viewers there that, you see, there could be 1 million singers, but there's just one singer. Who is you? There might be 1,000 orators, people who speak and they move and shake the world. But there is just one person who would speak like you.
Exactly.
There's one person who would speak and people will feel just that way.
Yes.
That nobody will make people feel when they speak.
Exactly.
That is the uniqueness. So even within gifts, there is something extraordinary about you and your gift and what you do.
Exactly.
And that's just how God has made us so unique. Because someone might say, Musumba, there are so many doctors.
Yes.
I don't know if I'm... No, there is that doctor who is in you that is not in any other man.
I never planned to touch that. But let me touch that also. You know, the word in Genesis chapter 1, 26.
Yes.
Let them have dominion. Dominion is, in Hebrew, is the word mamraka. Mamraka is a word that means, it has, you know, in Hebrew, words have slashes, you know, many meanings. But some of the meanings of that word is to master. Let have master, to rule, to govern, to control, to lead, to dominate. Now, that is the word, let them have dominion. Let me talk about that slash that you've talked about, to master. There are many doctors, but God is saying, if you find your gift, you must master.
Master your gift.
There is, that you know, there is having a gift and there is mastering. That's why the word mamraka has that meaning of rule. You know, rule comes from the word ruler. You set the standard. Set the star. You know, do it in such a way that there is no anyone else that can do it the way you do it.
Yes.
So, if you're talking about gifts, you know, there are many doctors. You need to master. Which kind of doctor are you? If you're talking about mastering, you're talking about even character. The way you treat the you know, there are
the
some,
way you do it, developing your craft.
Exactly. Develop your craft in a way that no one else can do it the way you do it. So the problem we're having, that's why people are so much worried about, there are many this kind of people and what of you. The thing is, you've not mastered. You know, the problem, you know, one of the problems that psychologists have found out is that the most biggest problem of human race is identity crisis. It is not even HIV AIDS. It's not even malaria. It's not even about, it's not even poverty. It is identity crisis. The challenge is we are living in a
identity
generation.
Identity crisis.
Exactly.
Yes.
We are living in a generation where people need to be another person.
People want to be other people.
And this has been always happening.
Let's say you idolize Celine Dion, you want to just sing exactly like
that. That is your challenge.
That's the challenge.
You are not created to be like that. And that is the same thing that Esau did. In fact, Jacob did to Esau. You know, the prophecy had come out that the younger is going to be the leader of the elder. And the young was Jacob. But the thing is, when time came for the blessings, this guy had to put on, you know, the hairy kind of body to look like Esau. so that he can grab the blessings. Things don't work that way. You don't need to copy. You don't need to be any other person. You just need to go to God and be yourself and master yourself. And let me tell our viewers, you have to know this. One thing, you don't, not all of us have to do these bigger things. Like, you know, some people are like, yo, I have to be like Daniel on television. I have to be like Savant, you know, being on this media house and the other. No, it doesn't work that way. Not all of us have to be, have to do those big things. No, the thing is, there are those people that were born to do those small things. Mm. But let me tell you this.
They are the unsung heroes. They are there.
Exactly. Yeah. But however small they are, the world cannot get rid of them. Let's talk about this lady that, you know, poured the oil on Jesus. We don't even know her name. Some people think she was Maria or what, but the Bible doesn't say that. She just poured the oil on Jesus. But Jesus said, whatever the gospel shall be preached, this lady shall be remembered. Let's talk about the adulteress that these people, the Israelites, came
to hit the adulterous woman with stones.
Yeah, exactly. Mm. No, I'm talking about in the Old Testament. Yes. There's that lady that hid these people want to come to spy. Exactly.
Rahab the prostitute.
Exactly.
Yes.
Think of, she just did one. She
did one thing. She
exactly.
hid.
But we can't get rid of her. You know. Let's think of in the Gospels of Jesus. We don't have any gospel for Andrew. We don't have it. We just have his name. But I tell you what, it is the Andrew that brought Peter to Jesus. It was Andrew that brought Peter. He just connected. And that is what he did. And we can't get rid of Peter. We can't get rid of the fact that it was Andrew that brought Peter to Jesus.
So it's the little, even the little things do count, really.
If it is yourself, if it is yourself, you just need to master yourself. That small thing. Mm. Let's just talk about... this is very simple. We have Bibles here. We have Bibles here.
Yes.
Look at the Bible. In the Bible, we have, let's talk about words. Yes. We talk about, there are commas.
Yes.
They are the full stops. You know, let me just stop at that. You know, a full stop in a statement makes a meaning. If it is not there, the statement is very different. If it is there, the statement is totally different. If the full stop is not there, the paragraph is very different and awkward. But if it is there, it makes a different meaning. This is the same thing. There are those people in life who are just full stops in life. When they are not there, the meaning is totally different.
The meaning is distorted. It is something.
Exactly. So we just you just need to discover yourself. And I'm telling you what, like when you go to a marketplace, if a person comes in a marketplace and a person needs maybe, I don't know how it is called, this Goa thing. You know, we have types of sugar cane. You know, you have this local one, and you have the Goa, you have the Monubi and ABCD. But if a person comes and he's like, I want Goa sugarcane, you can't give him a Monubi thing. No, the person, these are all sugarcanes. But the thing is, there is something, there is a certain kind of sugarcane that I really want.
There is something I'm looking for.
Exactly.
And it is in Goa.
Exactly.
You can't tell me about this.
You can't tell me about this. In fact, some people are like, no, I don't know. It's like, you don't respect me. How dare you tell me? I've told you I want Goa. How dare you tell me I take Monubi or I take this local one? And if a person has come for local one, you can't give him a Goa. So that is how things work. In this life, you just need to master yourself. Onto this phone, there's a company that does the battery. A different company. There's a company that produces the earpiece. Different company. There's a company that produces this cover. A different company. But all these have mastered this. Until your life, if we say your name, there is something that we know about you. You've not yet discovered your gift. Until we can say that.
Master your craft until we know that Daniel is such a photographer.
Exactly. Until, because that, if we say your name, you just imagine, think about yourself. If we saw if you say your name, what do we think about? If we don't have anything, let me tell you this. There are these people who are just good at cleaning. And they master cleaning. Like how you see Vision Group here. If you can master cleaning, I'm telling you, they can even fire you. But when they fire you, the environment changes. And in just a short while, they're like,
they will call you back.
Let this guy come back. Because we can't bear this kind of life. I'm telling you, you need to master. Inside, and God, we are talking about business. We didn't even tell people. We would have told them in the beginning. We are talking about your business.
Mm.
Yes. If we talk about your, if you are talking about your gift, you are talking about your business
your
in
gift,
life.
Your gift is your business
exactly.
in life.
This is your wealth.
It's what you came to say.
Exactly.
It's what you're offering. These are the solutions that you're giving to the world, and the world is paying you for these solutions.
And this is what we are going to pay for. You should know. If you've not discovered your gift, that means you are not paid worth what you are.
And we are all worth a lot.
A lot.
Come to think about it. We are all worth a lot. God has given you the gift that is going to sustain you. You know?
Yes.
The Bible says in Isaiah 48, if only, 48, 18, if only you had paid attention to my commands, then your well-being would have been like a river, like flawless.
Well-being.
So your well-being would be like yes. a river. You would be rich. You would be so,
yes.
your family would not
yes.
lack.
Yes. Not only in this life.
There's something inside you.
Exactly. That you need to, that's why.
That you need to discover and master it.
Exactly. And mm. that's why we trust our lives to God. Because, you know, he needs to work on our gifts. He needs to, because God is a God of revelation. He just needs to reveal to you who you are. And when he reveals to you who you are, then he's revealing your wealth, your value, your success in life. Not only for you, but even to your family. Let me tell you this. I'm accountable to the poverty of my family. Very much accountable. And you are accountable.
To the poverty of your family.
Exactly.
And yourself.
Exactly. Because the thing is, God brought you here with a solution. And people want solutions. All you need is to know, what did I come to do here? And the only true source that should tell you that, it is God, the Creator. The problem you're having, I always say, frankly, is the background of religion. You know, people worship God because, you know, they have this fashion of worshiping God. You know, they have, we love God. We go to church. You know, we praise. You know, we pray. We fast. You know, we go for intercession. And they have this fashion kind of stuff. But that is not the issue. The issue is we go to God because he's the manufacturer of our lives. And we go to him just to give us value. That is what he is saying. He reveals our value. And that is something that he's doing in his word. That is why he gave us his Holy Spirit. To help us master. To nurture us.
To refine us. Every
exactly.
day.
To prune us. To
prune us
exactly.
so that we stay focused.
Exactly.
We stay with in line with what he called us to do.
And,
you know?
And should I tell you what? If you discover your gift, if Christ, if you allow your life to be dominated by Christ, I tell you what, there is no one, all people, all the market of other people just, they get rid of those. You know, if you allow Christ in your gift, you master it in such a way that no one else can try to do that gift. No, you know, if Christ comes into your trade, your gift, you're too good that no other people that can compete you. The reason why we have so much competition here is because people have not mastered their gift. They have not allowed Christ in their gift. Let me tell you this. Christ found Peter, a fisherman. And this guy was just disappointed because he didn't catch anything. But the Bible says, when they believed the word of Christ, they caught fish, and even the nets were about to tear out. What do I mean? If Christ comes into your gift, he makes you master it, that you are beyond competition. You're too good into that. Because this is the creator of the whole universe. He knows the details, even what you don't know. I was reading today my Bible, and the verse says that it is God that sets boundaries on the earth. He knows the boundaries of your gift. He knows how much you can go. The reason why, you know, people were so, you know, fighting on jobs, you know, she's taking my job, he's taking my job, you know, I need to bewitch him, I need to, because you did not master. If you mastered.
If you only you spend your extra energy mastering your gift, rather than looking at what the other person has done better exactly. than you.
Yeah.
And trying to become jealous yes. and destroy them.
Yes.
I will fight with the story of Haman,
yeah.
Esther, and yeah. Mordecai.
Yeah.
It is in the book of Ruth.
Of Esther.
Of Esther.
Yes.
You go back, read that story.
Yes.
This is exactly what we are talking about.
Yes.
Muzama, we have just 2 minutes.
Mm.
As we summarize, I know we'll continue with this discussion
yes,
next week.
We need to.
But in conclusion.
Yes.
What do you have to say as we close this week's episode?
No, one thing I should tell people is we are created for a very, very big purpose. That's why the Bible says that I was fearfully and wonderfully made. You are fearfully and wonderfully made. And if you allow God to discover your gift, if you allow God to work on your gift, for those that have discovered it, I'm telling you, sky is the limit. Not only this life, even if you are dead, this planet won't get rid of you, as they can't get rid of Abraham, they can't get rid of Abraham Lincoln, as they can't get rid of Moses, as they can't get rid of Jesus. They can't get rid of you if you allowed God to master your gift, to refine your gift, to discover your gift. That's why you need to read the Bible each and every day, because you are reaping your life. It is just taking you to your destiny, where you're going to be the head, not the tail.
Salvatore, need I say more? Thank you so much for being part of the show. But there's just one thing that I'm taking home with me, and you should take it home with you as well. It all starts with God.
Exactly.
Seek Him first. He created you for a purpose which is very unique to yourself. Secondly, when you discover your gift, stay put. Don't try to do it on your own. In other words, don't stay away from the source. Stay in the presence of God. Read His word regularly. I mean daily. Make His word your lifestyle.
Amen.
He will refine you. He will help you master your gift. He will reveal to you deeper, valuable secrets about your gift that are going to make you unique, and you will excel this year.
Amen.
If you do that. So God bless you. We'll meet again next week as we touch another very important topic. This year, we are all about moving. We must shift this year.
Amen.
Things must change this year.
Amen.
So God bless you. We'll see you next week. Keep it up.